Hello and welcome to Hadoop Exam Learning Resources. Now in this session, we will talk about the one of the last domain of the AWS Certified SysOps Administrator, Cost and Performance Optimization. So now, as name suggests, this is related to the how better you utilize your cost, basically, correct? So it should not be expensive, it should be limited as per your budget, and it should not overshoot the budget, etc. It is covered in this. And then performance, correct? It should be like, you should select the services capacity as per your performance requirement. So that is very important things you understand here. Now let's move here and understand the domain in detail, what exactly. So this is 16% coverage here again in the question. So relatively smaller topic, understand the features and how use them with efficiencies and their cost including. So whenever you choose your service, when you answer to questions, correct, you have to make sure like you are answering properly, correct, like based on the cost also. So always keep in mind in question when you answer, this is a cheaper solution or not. If it is an expensive solution, if there are two same solution, services solve your problem, then you need to make sure which one is cheaper and when answering the question. So that is what they might not explicitly ask, which is cheaper and kind of thing, correct? Sometimes they mention in the question like cost efficiency and etc., but sometimes they not mention it. So that is what the issues with AWS, correct? They don't explicitly mention few things. So when you answer your question, so identify underutilized resources and your current spending, services like which services you are helping here is AWS Trusted Advisor, Cost Explorer, AWS Budget and Billing Alarms. Utilizing tags basically for cost allocation. So you should utilize tags as much as possible so you can group by the billing, like which department specific billing if you have in your application, then you need to put the proper tags where like my cost is going on, kind of thing. Look at the feature of the services to manage cost optimization. Like services which can help you to do this is AWS Compute Optimizer, AWS Spot Instances, services with reserved capacity for EC2, RDS, Redshift, DynamoDB, etc. So reserved capacity matters here. Basically, when you reserve it in advance, and that may be cheaper basically compared to like on demand. On demand sometimes may be more expensive, but when you go for this one, like reserve one, it would be cheaper option. Always try to utilize managed services because the services which provided by Amazon, and these are managed services, like Amazon itself take care of managing those services, then are relatively cheaper than what you put your own services. Yeah, that is a strategy which Amazon follows. So like you bound to the AWS itself and you don't move to any other cloud provider. So that is what their strategy basically are, to make you bound to an AWS, correct? So it is up to you how do you want to design it. If you want to go for independently with any cloud, then you should basically, when actual implementation, you should avoid Amazon specific services, correct? That would help you to like cloud independent. You can use Azure, Google Cloud, Alibaba Cloud, and Redshift, IBM Cloud, Oracle Cloud. There are many coming in, and there is going to be a huge competition for this cloud, correct? So in future, so keep it in mind when actually you design your solution, whether you are able to migrate to different cloud or not. That is very critical thing here. Obviously in the exam they would not ask question where it easy to migrate on the different cloud. They would try to focus you on how to stick to AWS cloud, correct? So that is what their strategy. So but actually when you implement, if you are a manager, you need to keep in mind basically whenever in future if the cost is high and you wanted to migrate to different cloud, then you should be able to do that. Okay, so that is what when actual implementation happens. Understand managed services such as, like that's what I'm saying, RDS. Very similar services provided by Google Cloud as well, correct? Azure as well provide their own managed databases. So that is every cloud provider provide this, and that is their strategy to stick to their own solution. So that is where they are making it cheaper than the third party solution. Then these are the managed solutions, RDS, AWS Fargate, EFS, etc. Then performance management perspective, you need to know like whatever services you are utilizing. Like you must make sure, like if let's say for example you need only a CPU with a 16 CPU machine, correct? Like you reserve 16 CPU machine, but you need only like 8 CPU only and 256 GB RAM. If you but your utilization is only 8 CPU and 8 GB RAM only is their utilization, that then this is unnecessarily you are paying for heavy instance, correct? I would say, why do you want to? So that is cost optimization. You should plan to move to this instance, which is like, it could be like, let's say I just for example I'm saying, correct, $30 a month, $32 a month, and this could be just 10, not even 10, even $8 a month, correct? So this is just reduction of 1/4, like you are just it having at 1/4 cost this instance, and the same activity is happening and same thing and same performance you are getting it. So that is what you need to make sure, like whatever you reserved it or you occupy it, it's really that much you need it. Sometimes it may not need it, and oversubscribing it just an expensive. So to make your job safe, use this basically, correct? Go make sure this is, because it's finally affect your performance basically if you wrongly use the instances. Higher billing, company will focus on that and then will ask you to optimize it, and if they found it like you are over utilizing unnecessary resources, then they can basically a problem for you, correct? So considering EC2 optimization, configure proper instance type which you want to use, what do you really need, memory, ephemeral storage, compute power, what is all your requirement really basically, correct? Based on that you need to choose your instance type. Enhanced networking placement group, if you need a good latency between two instances, like which is EC2 instance is in AZ1 and another instance is in AZ2, and then like kind of thing, how do you manage this latency basically, correct? That is what you need to make sure. Placement groups, if you put all the instances in the same placement group, you would have more better performance basically, low network latency, correct? AWS EBS matrix and configuration, you should use it to identify the you are properly utilizing the EBS volume or not. So S3 performance feature, S3 transfer acceleration, multi-part upload, correct? So sometimes what happens, terabytes of file or logs you want to upload to S3 bucket, correct? So what you need to do basically, you use the multi-part options. So multi-part option, what it does basically, it split your file, basically not split exactly, but it conceptually and parallel it loads this file into this S3 bucket, and once it is uploaded here, then it's combined again basically, correct? So it is very fast approach to load your, so this is a give you the performance boost. RDS matrix, you should know like performance optimization, performance insight for, so relational data management here basically which Amazon provides, so that is called RDS. You need to understand that most feature configuration part of service itself, rather than you doing going here and there, the most configuration you would be doing, it would be part of your service itself. Hence, you should be able to handle as part of the service itself. Subdomain 1, so that is what we have been discussing, then this is the same thing which we have discussed, correct? So you need to understand what are the spot instances, when do you want to use the spot instances, correct? So like this is all the tools and services you need to keep in mind. Now subdomain 2, what it says basically, recommended compute resources based on your performance matrix you should use it. Monitor Amazon EBS matrix and modify configuration to increase performance efficiency. Implement S3 performance. I think the same thing we have discussed few minutes back. So yeah, so this is all you need to understand. So I would be giving you this PPT. So you can basically access it and you can go over this and see what exactly you need to read it. So you can create your checklist on this all services which we have discussed previously in module 1, and as on when you do the study, you mark it basically whether you are comfortable or not on that particular service basically, correct? As you know, like these are the services which we discuss in module 1, correct? So Just go over this services. If when you become comfortable, mark, check mark it. Okay, I'm comfortable with this service, so I'm good to go on this. Correct. So that way you can manage it basically. Okay. So let me enable the drawing here. So basically you can see, like, if I'm done with the AWS control tower, I can mark it. I'm good on that. If I'm red, understand AWS CloudFront, I'm good on that. So that way you can just make it. And once you become comfortable to all the services, then you can say I'm ready for the AWS CISOF certification for associate level. Okay. So this all knowledge not only going to help you on the associate level, but also this is the same thing you would be reading it basically, and it would helpful for you DevOps certification, correct, professional level certification. That would, you can utilize the same knowledge. Obviously there would be some additional content for that, because there is a professional level certificate, so mastery is expected there, so there would be much more detail is expected. We'll discuss that later. Okay, so that's all about this CISOF, and thanks for watching. And if you're watching on YouTube, please don't forget to subscribe it. We are keep uploading new you can see videos regularly, correct. So before like that, I wanted to just go over this basically what you can say, this Hadoop exam website. So this is an Hadoop exam website which you can see here, like homepage, where you click on the Amazon AWS, it would launch this page where all AWS products are launched listed. Click on this CISOF one, it would open this page. On this page you can see like video introduction, practice paper, all are available. Once you click on video introduction, it open new page where all the videos would be listed here. Okay, so we'll be adding the videos here once we are done with that. So by the time you are watching this video, this would be already available on this page. So thanks for watching. I'm stopping now.